Okay, what's up guys? Welcome back to another episode of my Zelda Let's Play. In this episode, we chose to pick the fool's journey and head down into this chasm as deep as we can go. Now we're doing the gloom's approach, central Hyrule depths. Who knows what this chasm holds, but on the minimap I can see a little cog icon, a little icon of a gear. And so I'm like, okay, if this really is the deepest point, which of course we don't know if it's the deepest point, we just assume it's the deepest local point. We're like, certainly we can activate this gear somehow, and then maybe that'll count as some sort of a progress. But for now, we're just like stuck in the depths. Try saying that 10 times over. I captured this footage over a month ago, as you might have known if you watched the previous episode. So I don't quite exactly remember everything that I did. But I'm fairly confident that right now, Past Lee is trying to figure out what this gear icon is about that's on the minimap. Of course, we're out of stamina, so it's foolish to keep climbing. We don't want to get hurt or whatever, so we're just gonna run around a little. And of course we do see something over there in the distance that almost instantly grabs our attention, and I feel like we fought one of these guys before, except it wasn't as menacing. I hit it with my arrow straight away, and that's quite something. And now it is shooting balls of energy at us. That's new, isn't it? The previous versions of these things that we fought certainly did not shoot balls of energy at us. So I think it's only fitting that we tried to murder the son of a gun and see what it's about. Of course, based on what we've encountered in the in what was left of the castle in the previous episode, And how much worse we're guessing these depths are than the castle, I don't anticipate that we'll be making much progress against this fella. I see that we're still just fighting the fella, making no discernible progress, and I'm grateful because I've got a hell of a nose on me today. I can't tell you why, like really, I don't know why, but I need to keep the sucker clear. All of this I consider to be very gross, so I'll probably blur it out in post-production. So fear not if you cannot see what I'm currently doing. It's all by design. Luckily, on the screen, as you can see, we're fighting this this fella, tree snake, and we've given up on that, I suppose. So we're just jumping right past and seeing how deep we can really get. And lo and behold, we could get a lot deeper than we've already been. But now there are some other enemies. Enemies that are not stuck to trees that are chasing us and that whack us for 3/4 of our HP in one single blow. And now we're climbing into some obscure little cavern, some obscure little nook. And we're like, what the hell are we gonna do now? You know, we are screwed at this point. There's no question about that. Look, our HP, our stamina is finite, and we are just about out of HP. We do remember that there was something that we could take to undo the gloom. Don't quite remember what it was, but if we can maybe take that plus some food, then we can heal maybe. Sunderlion. Yeah, it restores the something something, but we can't eat it just like that. Probably we need to process it. And so now, of course, it's not lost on us just as hood we are to the, in here. And as such, I don't know if I slipped and fell or if I just said screw it and fell to my death and called it a day at that. And so now we're back at the gear icon and we're considering our options. Do we go down there and die some more? Or do we go back to the surface and realize that it was all very well and interesting being down here, learning about this place, but obviously we are not leveled enough for this place yet, and therefore we go back to the lookout, the sky view lookout tower, and try to do something more sensible. And it seems that we choose the more sensible option and we return to the sky view tower. And with what luck, because look at that fella standing right outside the tower that we apparently ignore. No, we don't. We talk to him. Well, look at this. You're the one I saw flying around the sky. It's great to meet the first one to ever be launched from a Skyview Tower. A real historic moment. Hey, what's your name? Link, you say? Hold on there. Really? Your name is Link? Hey, buddy. You've got the same name as that famous swordsman. Ha! Good for you. Pretty big name to live up to, though. Pretty big indeed. Pretty big indeed. I'm Penn, by the way. I work for the Lucky Clover Gazette. I'm writing an article about this event so folks everywhere will know about the Skyview Towers being activated. I'd better get to work. Our newspaper is short on staff, so I've had to flap all over the place to cover the news. Ah, okay, you're a journalist. Hey, we could use another reporter. You should join us. Seem like a brave type and all. That's what it takes. Our newspaper is based in Hebron to the northeast, northwest. There, you'll find it near the bridge that leads to Rito Village. Stop by if you're up for the adventure of a lifetime in the newspaper biz. Until then, soar long. I love it. I'm very much into adventure of a lifetime. You know, IRL, seriously, is very much into the adventure of a lifetime. Okay, so we decide to just get shot again. Can't really tell you why, I don't remember. But let's see what Seriously of the Past does. We're gonna do some floating. We see some interesting markings on the floor, which we hardly even look at before moving on. We see there's a pinned location, maybe we'll go there. We see a little pond, and then nothing, apparently. And so what do we decide? It seems that we decide to go to the pinned location. Yeah, that sounds like something I would do. I would want to increase my hearts. I would want to increase my stamina so that I could stop doing these tactical retreats that I've been doing every time I'm in a fight, because it's embarrassing, you know? It's one thing if you're playing this game on your own and you're all on your own in your living room or your gaming room or wherever it is that you play games. And you run away like a baby. It's a whole different thing if potentially the whole internet watches you run away over and over and over again. So let's go get some HP, let's go get some hearts, some stamina, etc, etc, and then hopefully that'll help us. Yeah, cool. We have landed. What do we here? We've got some cranes, and now we've got some lunch. Raw bird drumsticks. Yes, please. Sounds delicious right now. Some more drumsticks, some more lunch. That sounds amazing. They haven't heard of second lunch, Pippin. And that's what's really up. I tell lizard, you didn't care. Ah, you didn't take it. And it took too long to realize what you were standing on, so... Anyway, yes, some more of that other fella's construction equipment. Love it, thank you. I really need to start getting more creative with building stuff, don't I? Like cars and stuff with sails and whatnot. But of course we see a fellow human off in the distance fighting some bokoblin. We do realize that they don't need our help at all, but of course we're gonna jump right in and take the final killing blow and pretend that we did all the work. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. Sorry that you had to find out this way. Kalisa says, are we already monster free? Good. Look at you swooping to save me in the nick of time all over again. Here, take this as thanks for helping me. I'm sure you'll like it. Rapid summon fruit. The name's Kalisa. I'm a legendary treasure hunter from Gerudo. Nice to meet you. Have you heard about the strange phenomena going on all over the regions of Hyrule? Islands floating in the sky and caves opening up everywhere. It's a dream come true for a treasure hunter. Lately, I've been interested in the rubble and stones falling from the sky. I've even been dreaming about them. My latest dream? This big stone came tumbling out of the sky and hit the ground and then suddenly started to float back upward. I grabbed onto it, and before I knew it, I had arrived at an island in the sky full of treasure. Can you imagine? I simply cannot. Anyway, that was basically the whole dream. Too good to be true, of course. Of course. Why would I dream about a falling stone flying back up into the sky? Dreams are so strange. I better get going, but I hope we meet again. Sev Orc. Yeah, totally saved your life. Totally. Didn't just take the last hits on that monster and then pretended that I did all the work. It's true. But yeah, now let's get back to the Yamino Shrine in Hyrule Field. And let's do a shrine. Let's do a shrine. Let's get one step closer to another heart container or a stamina container of something or something of the sorts. Combat training, throwing. Oh, these are the best shrines because they're so easy. They're so easy. You just throw stuff. You know? Sorry guys, I've got a nose on me and it is just driving me crazy. So yeah, let's see what this guy has to say. This shrine purifies the ancient evil. You have who have entered here, heed my instruction. Okay. Aim true and throw the material. Will do, will do. Give me the material. Your other attacks are ineffective here. Ready yourself. Very well. Throw material. Select material from your inventory to throw. R to... Okay. Whatever. Can we throw one of those stakes? No, don't throw a bog goblin horn. Throw a stake. Well done. Okay. Apparently that's the way to go. Watch the enemy's movements carefully, then throw the material at them. Really? Take a stake this time. No, one to the right. The stakes. Throw a chicken drumstick. Acorn. Throw an acorn. Not a splash fruit. Seriously, from the boss is very disappointing. I apologize on behalf of him, guys. I do apologize. Anyway, we got him with a splash fruit. Hells yeah. You have proven your mastery. Now proceed to the innermost chamber. I've proven my mastery by throwing two pieces of crap. Hey, that opened. That's mastery, I suppose. I kind of feel like now that I'm picking these fire fruits afterwards, I kind of feel as though I should have been throwing fire fruits. It's just me though. I don't know how you guys feel. I'm probably wrong. But it was just a little bit of a something that I felt. It's probably wrong. Never mind. Carry on. Let's watch the episode. Zonite sword. Is that strong? Don't know. Couldn't tell you, but let's grab it anyway because this axe is busy dying. So we'll grab the Zonai sword, which is only a 6, which is no stronger than the axe that we just threw away. But it's all the same because that axe was busy dying anyway. So anyway, treasure test. Am I right? Bomb flower times 3. Oh, thank goodness. We ran out of bomb flowers some time ago, I recall, and I've been feeling very vulnerable without them. So I'm very grateful that we got some. And now for the real reward. A light of blessing. Haha. Thank you. Be seeing you guys. Keep well. Keep strong. Etc. etc. Okay, I'm back. Okay, what's happening? Why are we sliding down? Is it raining? I don't know if it's raining per se, but there's a fat korok down there. There's a bigger tower to the right, and there is a korok flower to the left. Yeah, okay, we need to chase this flower down. Where did it pop up now? Okay, now it's over there. Can I get this flower now that it's raining? Let's try. No, I cannot. As soon as it starts raining, you can't climb anything, man. You just start sliding down. So, and we're starting to attract sparks. You know what that means. Unequip all of your electric, all of your metallic equipment. Otherwise, you might find that a bad omen finds you pretty quickly. And I'm not ready for that right now. I'm not ready for that on screen just yet, if you know what I mean. Maybe we'll show off what happens in some distant future episode, but not right now. Now what are we doing? Okay, there's a time lapse. This tells me that we are trying to make a vehicle. Why would we try to make a vehicle? We can't exactly steer it or whatever. I guess we just want to place it. Hey, who's this fella? Hey, don't it feel like it's been one weird thing after another since the upheaval? Yes, it kind of does. The other day, my precious hammer that I've loved and cared for since, well, since forever, just up and rotted. It was beyond fixing, so I slapped a rock onto a wooden stick and had me a new hammer. Well done, my guy. It might not be pretty, but it beats a rotten old hammer any day of the week. It's true. Okay, well, nice to meet you, fella. I'm going to use my improv... shall we call it a skateboard of sorts? Some sort of a expedition machine of sorts, just to head in the same direction as you, because I attached the fan wrong way around. Let's unattach it, change it around, reattach it, hit it again, and off we go into a forward direction. I don't quite remember where we're going, but I can only assume that we're going to the purple pin on the map. It's the only thing that makes sense to me. And why we're doing it via vehicle? Couldn't tell you. But how cool was that lightning strike? It was pretty cool, wasn't it? It was pretty cool. I'm not going to lie. We're trying to slow down our thing because look who we found. We found a simpleton, and we just skipped over some difficulty that we had with parking our vehicle, so we just flipped it upside down and put it down on his head, so that we could quickly help the simpleton again, which we decided we're just going to use the exact same strat again, which is to make a little roof. Is this a roof? I kind of want to call it a steeple, but it's not really a steeple. Anyway, we know what to do here. We've done this before. We just need to keep the sign of Mr. Hudson standing. Even though the simpleton refers to the sign as Mr. Hudson. We just need to keep it standing and then everything should be good. Shouldn't be too difficult. We'll just make a roof again. Even though it looks a little bit weird. Doesn't really matter. Just stick it under there. Yeah, just let it go. Just like that. Should be fine. Addison. Oh, it's you. Thanks for... I'm putting President Hudson here too. But I can't stand here forever. I've got so many more signs to spread around. Of course you do. I don't know what to do. Try letting go. What? Are you going to support him? All right, I'll let go. Ta-da. Will he be okay? He won't fall? No, he won't. I've got you, boo. He's standing. How's the president standing? That was brilliant. I would have never thought of it. Of course not. Alright, let's get him secured while he's still standing. Just put this right here, get that fastened, and... boom! Perfect! You know it is. With your help, President Hudson is now standing proudly and firmly in place. It fills my heart with joy to see him doing so well on his own. Take this with my thanks. Red rupees, another 20 rupees, thank you. Also, you must be hungry after all that hard work, right? Let me give you a little something I might miss off. An energizing veggie rice balls. Thank you. But I still don't feel like I've thanked you enough. This is a little something from my premium collection, a special gift from me to you. A puff shroom, a mushroom that spreads a cloud of fine spores when stimulus is applied. The bitter powder makes them inedible. Okay, need to figure out what that's about. Fuse attack power. Now I can go to other places to put up more signs. And with that, I'm off. Okay, cheers, Addison. Thanks for the very generous reward again. Always nice to run into you. I hope to run into you again soon. But with that, we're going to call this episode a day. When we tune back in, we're going to see what the hell this skateboard does for us. This mechanical skateboard, let's call it that. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please let me know how you're doing in the comment section below, because I'm dying to hear from you guys, man. I really am. I really want to know how you guys are doing, what's going on in your lives, etc., etc. And if you would be so kind as to leave a like on this video, obviously only if you like the video, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't, it would really go a long way towards helping my channel. And then I will see you guys in the next one. Yeah, take care of yourselves. Cheers.